You're watching the Croydon Islamic Community Trust channel.
And then at the end of it, at the end of this time of sitting, Allah Ta'ala take the angels as witnesses that He forgave all of us, all of these people in this gathering. The angels may say, "Oh Allah, amongst them there is a man, so and so. He did not come for it. He did not come for this. He did not have intention to come for that. He came for other purpose. Maybe he wanted someone that he expected to find him only here, so he came to see him. Or maybe he wanted to have some rest or some whatever purpose." Allah Ta'ala says to the angels, they are the people who their companions or their sitters are not going to be destroyed or disturbed. I forgave them for them. And also in the other hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, and he quoted all Muslims, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. He said, when you pass by the gardens of the Jannah, the gardens of the heavens, then ارْتَعُوا. This word ارْتَعُوا in the Quran is mentioned only once in one place. That is in Surah Yusuf. When the brothers of Yusuf said to their father, أَرْسِلْهُ مَعَنَا غَدًا يَرْتَعْ وَيَلْعَبْ. Send him with us tomorrow, let him do this. يَرْتَعْ and يَلْعَبْ. يَلْعَبْ you all know. يَلْعَبْ means to play and enjoy. But what is يَرْتَعْ? What is يَرْتَعْ? I even asked this question to the Arabs, they did not give me proper answer, except for the ulama, of course. But the common Arabs, they did not give me answer. Yarta in Arabic means, you see when you go on a picnic, now in your house, how much meat you eat in your lunch? How much meat? 1 kg? No one can eat 1 kg of meat. 1/2 kg, maybe 1/4. But when you go on a picnic and barbecue, you may eat more than 1 kg. This is the, you know, way of picnic, because you're going to play, you consume the food and you eat and you enjoy it, you like it. Huh? Now the Prophet ﷺ is comparing these circles to that thing, you know. Eat a lot, eat a lot. How you eat in these places, don't bring food and drinks into the masjid. Blame me later on. But I mean, eat the ilm. What do I mean by eat the ilm? In the end means take as much benefit as you can. Record, write down the benefits that you have, pay attention, don't use your phone, don't talk, don't, you know, think outside. You know what I mean? Ask if you don't understand something, participate in the circle. And by that, you do this thing. فَارْتَعُوا as the Prophet ﷺ said, when you pass by the gardens of the heavens or of the Jannah, فَارْتَعُوا. The Arabs did not ask Rasulullah ﷺ about the meaning of فَارْتَعُوا, because they know it. It means take as much as you can. But they asked him, وَمَا رِيَاضُ الْجَنَّةِ. He said, what is the gardens of the heavens? Where can we find them? He said, Hilaq al-Dhikr. He said, the circles of Dhikr. Dhikr here does not mean Dhikr, yani we make circles and start do Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah. No, not this one. Because Abdullah ibn Mas'ud condemned this type of Dhikr. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, not someone today. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhu came to his house and he told him, "Oh Abu Abdurrahman, today I saw something in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that I found strange. He said, Subhanallah, what did you see? He said to him, if you stay alive until you reach the masjid, you're going to see it. And then Abu Musa said to him, he said, I saw the people sitting in circles, circles, circles. And they are doing dhikr. Not the bid'ah dhikr that the many people do today, who, Allahu. Nah, the dhikr which is upon the sunnah. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah. But this way of gathering on dhikr is bid'ah. So Ibn Mas'ud came to one of those circles and he said to the people there, what are you doing, people? What a quick destruction that falls on the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's grave, yet his clothes did not wear off, did not worn off. Here the boots of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are not yet broke. It means that he just passed away recently, just recently. So how come you be misled like that? They said, oh Ibn Mas'ud, may Allah's mercy be upon you. What wrong we did? We are only doing dhikr. And then he condemned this way of dhikr. So what is the meaning of the dhikr in that hadith? When he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about hilaqul riyadul jannah, Riyadul Jannah, the gardens of the heavens, and he said, these gardens of heavens are hilaqul dhikr, the circles of dhikr. Here we understand the dhikr, here the ilm. As Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Nahl, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And from the ayah you can understand the dhikr in this ayah means ilm. Because he said, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ, he did not say إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَذْكُرُونَ. He said, إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. It means, if you don't have knowledge, you ask the people of knowledge. So dhikr means knowledge. And the best dhikr that you worship Allah with is seeking knowledge. Why? Simply because Allah Ta'ala did not take as witnesses for His oneness from human being except the people of knowledge. He said, شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ. Allah witnessed that there is no one worthy of worship but He, Allah alone. And the angels witnessed, all of the angels, not some, all of the angels witnessed. And the people of knowledge. When he mentioned, when he talked about mankind, he said, and the people of knowledge. Not all, but people of knowledge. So, and here Allah Ta'ala recommended those people of knowledge that they are the ones who fear Him the most. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Indeed, those who fear Allah the most are the ulama, amongst the slaves of Allah, mankind. So, nothing like seeking knowledge, nothing. There is no mean to go closer to Allah with like seeking knowledge. And you guys here have plenty of time. If you don't come to the masjid, you are going to go to somewhere else. You're going to go to somewhere. If you are in Mecca, if you are not in a sitting in a circle of knowledge, you are going to do tawaf, you're going to do. If you are in Medina, you're going to stay in the Rawda, you're going. But here, if you are not in the masjid in the circle of knowledge, where are you going to be? Watching TV, outside in the street, seeing these all bad images, hearing this loud music, and you know, smelling all that bad smell of the khamr. You know, this masjid is your shelter, ya ikhwan. Is your shelter. And here you raise your knowledge about your Lord. Here you please your Lord. Here you worship your Lord. So you let us come again and gather again in this place. Let the people see that this place means something to us Muslims. Don't turn away from the Messiah like those who turn away from the churches and temples. Let us, don't turn the Messiah just only for prayer. like many people do. They just come by the Adhan or Iqama and they just leave by the Salam. Now, the masjid at the time of Rasulullah was everything. It was everything. It was the hosting place, it was the teaching place, it was everything to the community. And that's why, first thing Rasulullah did in Medina when he arrived there, he built the masjid. He built the masjid. As Allah Ta'ala said, Masjid al-Usis ala taqwa min awwal yawm, ahakwa an taquma bih. And he, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, when he conquered Iraq, he told his Amir, the Amir of the army, he told him first thing you do, you go to, you know, Basra wasn't there. Basra is only made by Umar radiallahu anhu. So he told him to go to a plain land and through an arrow, see where it drops, and there you build the masjid and make the Muslims build their houses around. To be close to the masjid, to come to the masjid. And to come to the masjid for ilm. And Rasulullah said that the one who leaves his house going to the masjid for ilm is fi sabilillah. He is fi sabilillah. And he said that if he is killed, he is like the murabiteen. Murabiteen are those who are by the borders of the Muslim countries, Muslim territories, pushing away the kuffar not to come into the kuffar armies not to come into the Muslim land. Those people, the murabiteen, as Rasulullah said, if one of them dies, his reward will continue be written for him, like if he's alive until the day of resurrection. So by coming to the masjid for seeking knowledge, all these rewards given to you. All these rewards given to you. So what make it to a state? While you guys here in this country are in need for many, many ulama, yet you don't have any. So you yourselves take this chance, seek knowledge and go teach the people. Teach the people the truth. I don't say teach the kuffar, Christians and Hindus and Akhi, we are in need to teach our Muslim brothers and sisters. In this country, you know more than me that there are many people who call themselves Muslims, they are out of the boundaries of Islam. They call themselves Muslims, but they are completely out. Completely out. Example, the Qadianis. They have a clear existence here in the UK. And they consider themselves Muslims. But they believe that Mirza Ahmad Qadiani, Ghulam Mirza Ahmad Qadiani, is a prophet after Muhammad. This is kufr. So, are they in need to teach them? Yes, of course they are. Islam is not only for us. No, we need to expand this. We need to spread it. Many, many people think Bradwees, they believe that their awliya in the graves can do whatever Allah can do. This needs to be corrected. We don't need to go and kill them. Nah, we need to go and guide them. We need to go and take them from their hands out of the darknesses to the light of Allah, which is the knowledge. May Allah Ta'ala make our gatherings always in what pleases him and benefit us out of all these gatherings and make us from those who come on the day of resurrection in the queue of the scholars. Wallahu a'lam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi. Any question?